Thank you. Helicopter 0 Whiskey Contact. Helicopter 0 Whiskey, for planning purposes with the D-33, do you plan on being on the west side of the runway for the Boeing 001 Heavy pickup? Helicopter 0 Whiskey, Roger. Remain east of taxiway Alpha for an Embraer taxiing northbound, and I do have one arrival probably about 10 minutes out. Alright, 2777, change our final heading 10-19-3000, and let's expect to take off. Alright, and our 2777, two helicopters over the Boeing ramp on approach under the 163.
Wow, what a way to start a Saturday morning, right?
Absolutely. This is amazing.
Hello to all of you guys watching on Boeing.com. We are live in Everett, Washington, just north of Seattle, for the Boeing 777X first flight. I'm Josh Green with Boeing Communications.
This is Emily Sanchez with Boeing Marketing.
All right. And you know, it looks like the skies are gray today, but today is a lot better conditions than yesterday.
Yes, it definitely is. And it's unfortunate that we weren't able to fly yesterday, but of course, safety is a priority here at Boeing, and the conditions just weren't right for us to take off. As you mentioned, it's looking a lot better today. Winds are in better condition. There's more of a ceiling. So, we're excited to see the airplanes taxiing down now.
And on the webcast, you should be able to hear that chatter. That's air traffic control here at Paint Field. Keep in mind, this is a commercial airport, so there are other flights taking off. You know, a lot of people ask about that yesterday, Emily. It's like, hey, I can hear other flights coming in, going out.
Yep.
Why is it the 777X flying? But the parameters are different for first flight.
Yeah, absolutely. And it really came down to taking off in the north and head described that for us yesterday, that all the other aircraft taking off here yesterday were going toward the south, and we have requirements. We want to go out over the water and make sure that we're as safe as possible for this very first maiden voyage of the 777X.
And there were about 8,000 employees joining us yesterday on the flight line here. And let's just take a look at the highlights. You can see a lot of spectators over at the Future of Flight. Journalists were with us. That's 777X leadership greeting the thousands of people out here. Craig Baumann was on the right side in the flight deck yesterday. Van Chaney on the left side. Same for today. Look at those crowds. It was wet. It was windy. But we still had a great time yesterday. 8,000 people, and a lot of people are interested in this airplane. Total throughout the day yesterday, there were more than 450,000 viewers.
What a great turnout
on the webcast.
At least some of those are tuning back in this morning, because I think it's going to be a really, really great day to fly this airplane. But what a great turnout. As you can see on the video, those wingtips folding down yesterday, that was a really exciting moment for the teams. And then the aircraft sat and waited for winds, unfortunately had to taxi back in. And now we're looking live at the aircraft as it continues to taxi down the runway. Again, hopeful that we can take off and have this first flight this morning.
Emily, let's talk a little bit about now what's going down. I believe that's taxiway A at Payne Field, going down to the south end, taking off to the north. Let's talk about those customers.
Yeah, absolutely. So we've got a nice shot of the customers. Again, 8 world-class customers that have purchased this aircraft so far. ANA, British Airways, Cathay Pacific, Emirates, Etihad, Lufthansa, Qatar, and Singapore. A huge thank you to those. And very cool that we can have all of their tails up there on that first 777X.
Eventually, you can see that those folding wing tips are up right now. Eventually, those are going to fold down. Emily, let's talk a little bit about the length of that wing. Why is it so important?
Absolutely. So the wing is really incredible, 236 feet span, and it's a larger wing than the 777-300ER. So with all that extra wing area, it's going to be able to create more lift for the airplane. Now, that's really important on takeoff, one of the most important phases of flight, because it's going to create more lift, allowing the aircraft to not accelerate to such a fast speed. So for the same weight, we can take off with slower speeds. That means we'll have a shorter field length. So we can also take off with more weight, using up that extra field length, or we can use that speed capability to reduce thrust and derate the airplane as well. All things that help our customers be able to be more flexible in their operations, whether that's carrying more passengers and payload, you know, being able to use less thrust helps the environment and helps them in terms of maintenance cost and stuff like that. So the wing is really an incredible piece of this, and allowing this takeoff to happen today.
And it has taken Boeing team members and valued partners around the world to make this aircraft a reality. Let's hear from some of them on this big day.
Congratulations to the 777X first flight.
Welcome to the fleet.
We made it! Customers tomorrow!
777X rocks!
Congratulations, 777X! Way to go!
We did it!
Thank you for all your hard work and dedication.
Great job, 777X. Keep them moving.
All the hard work paid off. Can't wait to see this thing fly.
Go, 777X.
Way to go, 777X.
You rock.
Working together.
We love you, 777X.
It's pretty amazing to see how it all comes together.
It feels awesome. I'm proud to have worked on 777X.
Fly that 777X.
Revolutionary is what Boeing is all about.
It's a hot ride in the sky.
Way to go, 777X.
Welcome to the family, 777X.
From HPL.
All upper panel and lower panel.
And all the 777X, congratulations.
The best airplane in the next generation.
777X, let's do this.
Congratulations, 777X team. Another world-changing airplane.
Auburn is proud to support 777X.
Wishing 777X a great flight from Auburn, Washington.
Congratulations on your first flight.
Congratulations, 777X program, on your first flight from RMD.
Again, another live look down at Kane Field in Everett, Washington. We are just about half an hour or so north of Seattle in the Pacific Northwest part of the United States. Hello to everybody watching around the globe. What an exciting day for Boeing. What an exciting day for aviation. You are watching the 777X, the brand new 777X, taxiing onto the runway. This is the VIP area, which is close to that runway. You might have seen some of those yellow vests from the helicopter as the airplane was taxiing. Some of those are media, others are VIP. A lot of folks around the globe interested in this today.
Yeah, I'm so excited that people have turned out today as well. Again, unfortunately, yesterday we weren't able to take off, but today is looking a lot more promising as the aircraft continues to taxi down the runway.
And Ted, one of our pilots told us yesterday that the reason we take off to the north is that it's a lesser populated area. It's for the safety of the public. It's for the safety of Boeing crews. Safety is top priority.
Absolutely. It really is. And we want to make sure that we don't take off over populated areas, like you said, that we take every precaution on this maiden voyage of the brand new 777X. So we're going to sit here for a minute and just watch the airplane do its thing. And we'll come back when there's more action. And the winglets are folding down. Again, part of the 777X is those incredible wingtips that are going to fold up so it can fit in that Code E gate and then be able to fold down and have that full length span during flight, allowing it to have better aerodynamic capability and create that incredible lift that this wing is capable of. So just one of those steps in taking this airplane to take off.
All right, let's listen in.
And while we're here, let's take a shot of those GE9X engines. That's the largest fan diameter in commercial aviation. Just an incredibly large engine, a really high bypass ratio. One of those things combined with the wing on this airplane that allows us to be 10% more efficient than the competition. The 777X, really a revolutionary aircraft. Today is going to be the first day that we see the aircraft and those GE9X engines take flight.
It is just before 10 a.m. here in Everett, Washington. In the flight deck today, in the left seat, we've got Van Chaney, who is our chief 777X pilot. In the right seat, we have Craig Bauman, who is our chief Boeing pilot.
We see incredibly qualified pilots and a really, really good team up there in the flight deck. So they're going to make sure that everything is ready to go, everything is safe for this first flight, and they're going to take good care of that airplane.
We've had a couple commercial flights coming in and out of here. I think at this point that's what we're waiting on. But let's listen into the chatter and we'll learn more here in a bit.
Affirmative, you can overfly runway 16 right. Left down. 07 Romeo, safe flight condition?
07 Romeo, a little bit limited visibility over here.
Cessna 07 Romeo, right?
In fact, if you don't mind, any chance I can get a transition over to the Whidbey Island area?
Cessna 07 Romeo, westbound. Cessna 07 Romeo, traffic is up your left wing, half a mile helicopter.
So we're going to wait another 10, 15 minutes or so. The pilots are going to finish all of their checklists before they take the main runway. We also have those chase airplanes that we talked to Ted about yesterday that are going to take off from Going Field, make sure they're here to capture the action and help make sure this aircraft is safe in its first flight. So we'll take a few minutes and let the pilots do that.
And in the meantime, we have a video that shows the journey of this beautiful 777X. As the pilots do their final checks here and the chase planes come out from Boeing Field, we're going to watch another video. We are going to stay on this airplane. We're going to do a split screen so you can always keep your eyes on the airplane. But let's hear from teams around the globe.
You rocked it, 777X program.
You rocked 777X.
777X, elite composite.
From your 777X team down here in Long Beach.
777X rocks!
Congratulations,
777X.
Way to go,
777X.
777X be champions.
777X, engineering excellence.
Way to go, 777X.
Awesome job, 777X team.
Way to be leaders, 777X.
777X, going global.
Promises made, promises kept.
In Seal Beach, California with the 777X team. Way to go, 777X.
Awesome job, team 777X.
Congrats on the 777X first flight from the 777X team right here in Helena, Montana.
Have a great first flight.
Congratulations on the 777X first flight from the GDRC.
Congratulations, 777X from the Helena team. Keep up the good work.
Congratulations on the first flight from Portland Engineering.
Congrats on the first flight from Boeing Portland Central Assembly.
Congratulations, 777X from Portland.
Congratulations, 777X from Propulsion, South Carolina.
Woo!
Félicitations pour le premier vol.
Bravo, 777X.
Congratulations to the 777X team for your first flight from the UKE-17.
Sierra Mallorca!
For bombers here in Oklahoma City.
Congrats, 777X on your first flight.
From the F-15 leadership team.
Way to go, 777X!
Congratulations, 777X!
Congratulations, 777X from BOAC.
Woo!
777X rocks!
Congratulations, 777X! I work on the 777X.
I'm excited for first flight.
I'm really excited to have played a part.
First flights only come along once in a lifetime.
We spend so much time
in development
of a brand new aircraft.
It's been a journey.
Years of hard work.
Across the globe.
And I'm excited
to see this once in a lifetime opportunity come to full fruition.
And to see a bird fly.
So I'm super excited.
Go, or you need to be on the runway for 10 minutes. Flying 001 Heavy, Roger, stand by.
Helicopter Zero Whiskey Whiskey, did you want to be on the west side of the runway, is that correct? helicopter 0, whiskey, roger. Do not overfly runway 16 right, 34 left, and just maintain visual separation. Actually, continue, turn left at Alpha 4, kind of ground plane. I'm going through 01 heavy, roger. Going 09 right to Green Tower 7. X-ray pain tower, pain altimeter 2996, you can see it inside the platform. 1001 heavy, the T-33 is about 5 miles to the southwest now, inbound. Runway 34 left, line up and wait.
It sounds like the chase planes are almost here, and the airplane is moving to the runway. That's a great sight, Emily.
Absolutely a great sign. As you mentioned, just waiting maybe another short while on the chase planes, and then this airplane will take her maiden voyage. Turning out onto the main runway now.
One chase plane today. You might see it in the shot. Once again, the 777X will take off to the north. Here from Payne Field in Everett, Washington.
Air 4 report, departing heavy Boeing 777 in sight. Air 4 maintain visual separation, caution wait. Boeing 09er X-ray. Just wanted to make sure you overheard that. There's a helicopter low level, 100 or 200 feet, AGL, is going to be on the west side of 34 left when you proceed inbound. What altitude are you planning on being at?
You can really see how long those wings are now that it's on the runway. That's a good perspective, right?
Maintain visual separation with heavy Boeing 777. Just feed it back to the call center. Boeing 001, heavy, 34 left, clear takeoff.
Clear for takeoff. It's giving me chills.
Me too.
X-ray traffic also on the west edge of runway 34 left, helicopter at 100 AGL. Helicopter 0 with you. Boeing 09 X-ray, the helicopter will now be on the east side of the east side. Air 4, additional traffic will be Boeing T-33, currently over Edmonds at 1,000, will be low level paralleling the Boeing to the north. Boeing 09 X-ray reports departing heavy Boeing 777 and 6. the T-33 remain at or above current altitude. Boeing 09RX3, still report the heavy Boeing inside, please, and the helicopter traffic, the only one that's on the west side of the runway, is currently 1 mile west of 34 left at 2100 restricted at or above that.
And we just heard that the chase plane is 1 mile away, so getting closer and closer.
Boeing 09RX3, it does appear you've driven to the east side of 34 left. It's starting by you'll be on the west side of 34 left.
Here we go. Boeing 777X.
Woo! That was so incredibly cool to watch.
Through the clouds and filtered sunshine, the beauty of that airplane shines through.
Absolutely. The building anticipation since yesterday, what a proud moment for all these teams around the world like we just saw and all the people that came out to be a part of this today.
It feels like it's been raining here for 3 weeks and the sun has finally come out. What a spectacular takeoff.
It really, really was. I think it's a good sign.
Yeah. So tell us what happens now.
Yeah, so the airplane is going to do its flight today. They're going to try to open up the envelope, as our pilot Ted Grady was talking about yesterday. So they'll spend at least a few hours in the air trying to do some of that. And then they're going to land back at Boeing Field.
Okay, and we're going to head down to Boeing Field. You'll see us later today with that beautiful airplane. In the meantime, you can track the progress on our flight tracker on Boeing.com, and there will be updates on Boeing social media. Right now, let's take one more look at that beautiful, lovely takeoff, and we'll see you later today.